Hey friends, today we are going to visit this lighthouse. It is Points de Leon Lighthouse here in Daytona Beach. Okay, so here we go. We are going to climb to the top of the lighthouse.
Tallest lighthouse in Florida, second tallest in the country.
Thank you. Okay, so as you can see, we made it to the top.
How was that?
Scary.
All right, you ready to go back down?
No.
No? Let's see if I can. Oh, I'm getting to stick the GoPro on.
It's an acting lighthouse, and they have to basically go there to. So they used to have to use curtains during the day to protect the lens and everything from the Florida sun.
Uh-huh.
But that's because they didn't keep it spinning except for at night. And they figured out it was better just to keep it spinning all day than to worry about opening and closing expensive curtains. So now it just spins 24/7.
Interesting. So this was a really fun hike. As you can tell, I am still inside the lighthouse and I'm up by the lens itself. This is definitely not for someone with any kind of mobility issues, but the climb was a lot of fun. There are plenty of like platform areas that you can stop and let people go by and catch your breath. Totally worth it for the views. Oh, well, maybe it'll be there when you get back.
Yeah, I don't think you're going to. Oh my God.
Yeah, this first set of stairs coming down is definitely the steepest.
Yeah, for me, with my air heights, this is a two-handed job. I don't know how you're doing.
Very carefully. Very slowly.
Look at how me. Again, how I have to do this.
So if you're afraid of heights, would you recommend this trip for somebody?
Sure, yeah.
Just go slow.
Yeah.
Don't be in a hurry.
Go slow.
That's perfect.
This was a really fun experience. Now we're going to head on out and check out the rest of the grounds.
All right, so we have finished our climb up the lighthouse and we're going to check out the rest of this fun stuff down here on the ground level. Here we have the Kettige Anchor. Don't touch it, you might need a tetanus shot. And over here we have a 16th century anchor. And here we have the oil storage house. Let's get a peek. Channel markers, range lights, and day boards. Sorry about this, guys. It is super humid. Let's see if we can. Here we go. See a little bit here. The generator room. Just so you know, there are plenty of things that I'm not catching completely on camera because I want you to come out here and experience this beautiful lighthouse landmark and catch all the information for yourselves.
So this was a lot of fun. I am sitting on the front porch of one of the house buildings waiting for Zach. He likes to really dive in and read all of the information and watch all the little movies and tutorials and things. So you can really make a half day trip out of this if you really take your time to take it all in. This is a fun place to come with friends, family, loved ones. It's a nice little drive, short drive from the heart of Daytona Beach, and I highly recommend it. Come check it out. It's not very expensive. I'll put all the links in the description box below for you so you can get all the information you need to come out and see this too.
So I thought this was a really interesting display that they had here. I thought it was kind of neat seeing the different styles of rafts that had been made to use to try to make it over here to the mainland. And just off here to the side was a nature trail. I highly recommend walking through it. This was part of the nature trail. I just love that tree. And here you can see the Lighthouse Kitty Cat Graveyard. This building here runs a 20-minute video that replays every 20 minutes. Right next to the lighthouse was a park that you could easily stroll through and add to your day. There was also a really nice playground for the kids if they hadn't gotten all their energy out yet. And right next door was a place to stop and grab a bite to eat. That's all I've got for you today on this wonderful lighthouse trip. Please remember to like and subscribe. And until the next time, guys, shake a tail feather.